Hello everyone. In this first episode, I'd like to introduce two important concepts in programming, variables and methods. In our code, we need to be able to keep track of changing information, and this is where variables come in. So a variable is essentially a name to which we can assign some data. For example, we might assign the number 15 to the name player health at the start of the code. At runtime, in other words, while the game is actually being played, if the player takes damage, we can update the value stored in the variable. An example of this would be the line player health equals player health minus 5, which subtracts from the player's health by assigning the variable a new value equal to its old value minus 5. When we create a variable, we need to specify what type of data it will be holding. The player health variable, for instance, holds a number, so we might specify it as an int variable. This means it will only ever be able to hold an integer or whole number value. If we wanted it to be able to store non-whole numbers, what we refer to as floating point numbers, since the decimal point can be placed anywhere, we would make it a float variable instead. Other examples of data types include bool for storing true-false values, such as player is alive, and string for storing text, such as the player's name. As you can see, when we create a variable, we first specify its type, followed by a name of our own choosing. To assign a value to it, we then add an equal sign, followed by the value. Some data types require the values to be written in a certain way. For example, string values must be enclosed in quote marks, and float values must end with the letter F. Finally, a semicolon is added to indicate the end of that line of code. Don't feel that you necessarily need to memorize all of this right away. The main takeaway from this is simply that a variable is a name to which we can assign data, and that this data can be accessed and modified at runtime to keep track of the changing state of the game. Alright, let's talk about the next concept, methods, also known as functions. Methods are a little bit trickier to define in simple terms, so I'm going to explain them by way of an example. Imagine we write a bit of code for creating an explosion. So the instructions might be something like play a sound effect, then make a flash of light, and apply, say, 10 damage to all objects within 5 units of the blast. By the way, anything that follows 2 forward slashes on the same line is a comment in C#. In other words, it doesn't affect the code, but rather acts as a note to oneself or to other programmers. So in this video, I'm using it to indicate lines which are not actual code. Now, our game might have various objects that explode, cars, barrels, etc. So we could copy-paste the explosion code for each of these different objects. However, if we then wanted to make a change to the instructions, for example, add some smoke, we'd have to remember to go through all of the copies and make the changes there as well. You can imagine that this would get very tiresome, so as a rule, programmers tend to severely dislike code repetition. What methods allow us to do is to define a name to which those instructions belong. So we could create a method called explode and put all of the instructions inside of there. Now we can replace all versions of this duplicated code with single calls to that explode method. Let's extend this explosion example a bit. Currently, we have hard-coded values for the damage amount and the explosion radius, but what if we want the explosion of a car to be more powerful than that of a barrel? Instead of specifically saying apply 10 damage to objects within a 5-unit radius, we could say apply damage amount damage to objects within blast radius of the blast. We have replaced the hard-coded values with variables. We now change what is called the method signature to reflect this. So inside these parentheses following the method's name, we define the two variables that this method uses. Notice, however, that we don't give the variables values. Whenever we call the method, we can supply the values for those variables that we want. Here, when the car calls the explode method, damage amount is equal to 8 and blast radius is equal to 12, whereas when the barrel calls it, the damage amount is equal to 5 and the blast radius is equal to 10. Alright, so we've seen that we can pass data into a method, but we can also return data from a method if we want. Say, for example, that we'd like to be able to generate random names for the different characters in our game, so we make a method called generateRandomName. This starts off by defining an empty string variable called something like randomName, and then it follows some procedure to randomly add letters to the variable. Now we have a random name, but we're not done yet. Whoever's calling this method will obviously want to know what the result is. So, at the end of the method, we add the keyword return, followed by the variable our result is stored in, random name. In the same way that we have to specify the type of variable that we create, we also have to specify the type of data that a method returns. If it doesn't return any data, as was the case with our explode method, then we just have void before the name. Generate random name returns text, so we'd add string before the method name. Now, whenever a random name is required, we can say string name equals generate random name. What we're doing is setting name equal to the value that is returned from the generate random name method. So to recap, a method is a means of isolating code that performs a specific task so that it can be called from multiple places. It can optionally take in data to work with and can either return void, that is, nothing at all, or it can return a piece of data. I hope you found this video helpful. In the next episode, we'll be talking about classes. Until then, cheers.